1Password is a password manager. Who would have thought? But if that's about as much as you know about it, this video is gonna fix that. Get ready for a full 1Password review and a tutorial, your all-in-one guide to arguably one of the best providers on the market. Let's start with pricing, because I don't want to overspend on any security tools, as good as they might be. That's one of the reasons I really like 1Password. The individual and family plans are very affordable, and the number only goes up for business and team plans. Those are typically more focused on having a lot of users and having shared password storage between them, so chances are you don't need that. On the contrary, the individual and family plans provide the classic 1Password experience, with the only difference being the supported number of users. Naturally, if you only need the plan for yourself, then the family plan is simply just gonna be overkill. But it doesn't mean you can't try things out. The 14-day free trial applies to all the plans, so go for it. And once you find the plan that fits you, make sure to check the description below for the best 1Password discount. The deal is already applied. All you gotta do is click the link. Now, 1Password might be affordable, but that doesn't mean it's restrictive. Now, I've tried this password manager on all possible platforms since there are apps for all of them. When it comes to browsers, I typically use the 1Password Chrome extension, but there are extensions for other popular browsers as well. The apps and extensions are not completely the same. There are minor differences in appearance and structure, but the good news is that it doesn't create needless confusion. Switching between platforms never felt complicated to me, and I managed to look up my passwords, update old ones, and reorganize categories. The order of categories can be easily adjusted, and I even ended up hiding a couple of them, mostly the ones that I needed the least. But probably the most convenient thing here is the biometric authentication. I find it much easier to just scan my fingerprint or use Face ID depending on the device. No need to type the password every time. Security-wise, 1Password has a lot to offer. The encryption it uses to store our passwords is unbreakable and is considered a gold standard of cryptography. If that wasn't enough, 1Password follows a zero-knowledge architecture, meaning all data is encrypted and decrypted only on your device. So not only third parties, but the service itself has no way of accessing your passwords. Part of this design is a secret key, a special combination of symbols stored only on your device, without which accessing your data is not going to be possible. Now, while there are password managers that get too complicated and end up breaching, like LastPass, 1Password is a rare provider that acts proactively. It constantly undergoes independent audits and runs a bug bounty program. These features make up a security core of 1Password, but I'm not done yet. Biometric authentication, I mentioned that earlier, is part of the multi-factor authentication. This is what adds extra steps to your security, requiring the use of a mobile phone, one-time passwords, or biometry to open the app. This might sound troublesome, but trust me, it's better to be safe than sorry. Or you can put your entire faith in your passwords. After all, the 1Password password generator feature can create complex and unique passwords with a single click. All the passwords I use are generated just like that. And even if I don't use the 100 symbols limit, I can always configure the passwords just like I need them. Now, whenever I'm traveling, I use travel mode, duh. In this mode, only certain passwords can be accessed in the app. This way, I don't have to worry about all my passwords in case my device is lost or stolen. Now, some of these things are crucial security features, but 1Password doesn't stop at those either. For instance, there's password sharing, a feature designed to send passwords to other users through an encrypted connection. It doesn't even have to be another 1Password user, and you just need to know the recipient's email. The feature I find really convenient, though, is auto-filling. With this one, I can forget about copy-pasting every password by hand. 1Password is going to automatically suggest an account and password for the website saved in its database. Now, this can also be used with payment information, as 1Password can auto-fill virtual credit card information with certified merchants like Amazon. Now, out of all the 1Password features, the Vault Password Manager system is the reason that I find it the best option on the market for families. Vaults are essentially broad categories of personal information, and I can easily create vaults sharing specific passwords or data only with certain family members. And since vaults don't only save passwords, but also banking details, notes, documents, and so on, it's really easy to manage. I can just drag and drop anything saved in 1Password to a family member's vault. This applies to passkeys as well. Those are fairly new and a potential replacement for passwords moving forward. Those are always strong and phishing resistant. Another interesting feature is Watchtower. And yeah, you could probably guess where this is going. It watches for compromised logins, data breaches, or weak passwords. The feature is going to alert you anytime an issue is found. So I highly suggest you keep this feature on at all times. I know I do. And let me tell you, I think I'm ready for the next Facebook breach. Oh, and the final small privacy feature is an auto-cleared clipboard. Any copied information is erased from your clipboard in 90 seconds. Not a major improvement, but a nice way to make sure no sensitive data is pasted accidentally. Okay, I think at this point you know everything 1Password has to offer. So if you want to try it out for yourself, make sure to grab a subscription from the description below and get the best deal. Oh, actually, that's exactly where we start our 1Password tutorial with getting the subscription. So once you click under this video, you can get the 1Password trial. Yeah, 1Password has a 14-day free trial you must take, which is very surprising to me, especially because filling in payment details is not necessary to proceed. I really like that. There's just no risk of you forgetting about the trial and end up getting billed. In the worst case scenario, if you set your payment details, 1Password is going to send you a notice 7 days into the trial, reminding you that you're going to have to pay at the end. So once you register for the trial, you may want to get the subscription anyway to get the benefits of the deal and save money with a discount. With the subscription activated, you are then free to download an app for your device, let's say Windows for now. Once the app is installed, use your 1Password login to access the app. As soon as you do this, there's one thing to keep in mind. If you used a password manager before, you will have to transfer your data into 1Password. To do that, export passwords from your former app in the .csv format and then import them to 1Password. The steps are on the screen right now, so you can just follow those. In case you're starting from scratch, click this button to add your first passwords. There are a few things that you can customize here, such as the website it belongs to, who has access to the password, and so on. In case you're creating a brand new account, the password generator is right here, so simply by clicking this button, it's gonna give you a new password. Or you can simply create a passkey. It takes just a single click right here. Just keep in mind, not all websites support passkeys yet. So you gotta do a bit of research beforehand. Now that you have some passwords or passkeys, let's see how to share them. This is not complicated either. You just choose the password you want and click share. Here you can specify the email of your receiver of your password, which is gonna create a secure sharing link. Send it to the target person and they'll be able to get your password securely. You don't even need the password manager app to do that. Sharing is available through the web dashboard through practically the same steps. So you have your passwords and you know how to share them. Let's do some organizing with vaults. Once you click this plus sign on the sidebar, all you need to do is give your vault a name, the description is optional, and then just click create. Just like that, you have yourself a vault. All that's left is to fill it with your passwords. And just like its content, vaults can be shared using the same process I showed a bit earlier. Hey, if you've reached this far into the 1Password review and tutorial, you should know all there is to know about 1Password and how to use most of its features. This is one of the most user-friendly providers with an obligatory 14-day trial on top of the already affordable pricing. So with tons of security and compatible features, I consider 1Password one of the best password managers to commit to. So if you're curious about trying it out, you can always get a better deal through the link in the description below. Thanks a lot for watching and make sure to leave any questions in the description. I'll see you soon. Stay tuned.